Hello and welcome to this tutorial. I'm performing a 5G survey using iBwave's mobile survey and the Epiq PRiSM scanner. This video assumes you have performed a blind scan and documented the channels that you desire to test. With the mobile survey software open, select your project. Select your floor plan. With our floor plan, we have already preloaded the images. We've set our scale. We've set all this information that we've documented in a prior video if you need a refresher on that. Begin our survey. We will click on our survey tab. We're going to come over to the new survey. And within this option, I'll deselect this for the moment. You can see that we have the ability to do 5G, 4G, or P25 testing for public safety. Under our scanner option, the Epiq PRiSM scanner is the only scanner that is directly integrated with our software. That's where these options are available. You also can use the device hardware. So if you have a tablet or mobile phone that you're testing, if we select that option, you're able to do cellular or Wi-Fi. And that's going to be using the SIM card or the Wi-Fi radio within your testing device to record that information. For this example, we're going to stick with our PRiSM scanner. We are going to do 5G survey. You can do 5G and 4G at the same time. All you do is select both and make sure you set the band and channels appropriate for each. We're going to stick to just 5G on this one. Under bands, you're going to select the band that you want to utilize for your testing. This can include multiple bands. It's not just a single band. It can have up to 6 or 7 channels, is roughly where we say your max limitation is going to be. Once you have the band selected, we'll click on it again to hide it. Once your band is set, you want to set the appropriate channel to match it. Under here, I already have my 175.930 populated. If I did need to add any additional channels, I could just type in the channel number. I can select my plus button to add it. Alternatively, knowing that this is not real, I can either hit the minus button to delete it, or I can uncheck the box so that it will not be recorded. If I click on my channel once again, I can see I'm set up for a 5G, a single channel, 850 megahertz, and I can choose if I want to do stop and go or continuous, and we'll show both options. First, we'll show the continuous. So once we're ready, we can give our project a name. We'll call this one Demo 1. Click on Start. First thing you'll want to do is find yourself on the floor plan. We're going to start over here in the corner. Once I click, you're going to see a black dot originate. With only one channel, this is going to go from black to green relatively quickly. The more channels that you do add, the longer time it will take because it's going to go through. It's going to initialize the scanner, and then it's going to take the first iteration of data, remove it, and it's going to start recording on the second iteration. We record on the second iteration because your neighboring data isn't fully populated on the first iteration. So we let that first set of data go by, start recording on the second. That way you have all your neighboring information for your entire data collection process. I'm going to click to begin. We'll see how that went quickly from black to green. If you are doing your walk test, as soon as it goes green, you're able to start walking. If you were to stop it at some point in time, so let's just say security stops me, I would pause. I could always hit my pause button over here and resume if we knew it was going to be a long time period. Otherwise, I'm going to want to click my data point right on top of where I was stopped. That way, all that data gets dropped in that location, and then I can resume my walk. Just do a nice steady path. Every time I get to a point where I need to make a turn, I'm going to be the one to click because I am the GPS in this scenario. I am assuming I'm making a steady pace with my mouse. Obviously, I'm not in a real-world solution at the moment. But once we get to the point where we feel like we have adequate amount of data collection, we can click on our Done button. We'll click OK. We can easily see that under our legend, it shows us with the interpolation that we're passing at 100%. If I don't want to see the interpolation, you're going to see the values change a little bit because the interpolation is using this 10-meter ring that it puts around every piece of data. It looks at just the other data points to interpolate the data that we have. If you turn off interpolation, you're going to see that it's just the raw data. It's going to, and your legend, everything is based off of just the raw data at that point. As well, the interpolation is only taking the area that you did the outline. The stairwell that's up here was not included. So if I turn my interpolation back on again, you can see I told it to exclude the stairwell from being included in the pass fail grade. I did note that we do have two different versions of testing, the second one being the stop and go. Let's just say you missed a few locations, or maybe it's a scenario where you're putting in a BDA and you only need to have a few test points on a rooftop that's going to show where the Yagi's going to go. I'm going to leave everything exactly the same. 5G, my band, my technology. I just changed my survey mode to stop and go. If I click on start, and since we only want to collect on a few points here, when I click on a location, so this is going to be our cafeteria area, I can click on it. We can see that's going to go from black to green. You can see that one just took a few more seconds. Now my walk path doesn't matter because I'm not collecting any more data until I get over here to this conference room. I want data inside there. Data is recorded. Same concept. I come over here. This is where the reception is. I collected it. They do have an additional conference room over here that we didn't get data in. I can click it. Data is collected. So it's just a stop and go. It's only going to collect where you need it. So if you don't need a full data set collected, you can easily do that and be able to just collect the important points that you're looking for. Once you're done, we'll click on our done button. We'll tell it's okay to save our data. It's processing it again. It's going to show both data points at the same time. If I do not want to see that, I can easily go into my setup section and I can turn one or the other off. So if I didn't want to see my stop and go version, I could just uncheck it, come back in here. I have everything in there. Maybe you had a daytime walk and you didn't have access fully inside of a building. You could come back and do the access area that you had to have security come in at night with you and escort you around. You could show both of them on the same map without having to go through and take this to any type of third party post-processing. And as noted, if I do have both of these on at the same time, I can do either my interpolation or not. With this version, with me not having interpolation turned on, it's taking all the dots into consideration, just the raw data, none of the interpolation portion of it. From this map, we can say that 100% of this is at minus 95 or stronger, and 66% of it is at minus 90 or stronger. If I want to dig into my maps a little bit more, I could select my technology selector at the top. We already set our technology, so if you did have different bands in here, you would be able to go through and change your frequency, or even if you have multiple channels within the same band, you can go through, select the appropriate channel so you can see each individually. If there are multiple PCIs collected, you would see a list here. So under this example, PCI 231 is the only PCI for that channel. I'm showing the RSRP map at the moment. You also have the option of RSRQ, SINAR, or RSSI. There are some additional maps that are listed in here that's going to be cleaned up in a future version of software. So now that you have your data collected, now you need to create a report. We click on our back button. We're going to come back to our floor plan. Up here at the top, you'll see a PDF icon. This is for running our reports. This is going to be a project report. You can tell it to either include or exclude any of these options. You can have a title page, the plans. This will show a blank floor plan. We don't need to see that on this example. Annotations, so if you did record any kind of annotations and you want to have a map with that, we'd include that as well. Survey map is where we have our data collection at. If I want to look at my options, I can go through here, look at the different technologies. I did have a different map on here prior, so that's why I'm going to have that deselected. If I use my sprocket icon here, I can choose these four options. These are the four that were available within mapping. If I didn't want to see RSSI, for example, I could easily just uncheck it. But we're going to leave all four for this example. We'll click OK. And then you have the interpolation. You can enable or disable it. So whether if you want to see just the raw data or see more of the color heat map version, once we click our back button, we can now select run. Take note of where it's going to save your report at. By default, give it a project name and a date and timestamp. You can change either if you desire. Click on save. It's going to go through, prepare the file, then save the file in the PDF format, and it'll open up for us. Here is our title page, and then it's going to jump into our A50 cellular 5G. This is our RSRP, RSRQ, SINAR, and our RSSI map. If we were to unselect the stop and go map, which we can see on here, it would only show what was selected when you go to run the report. So if you have multiple surveys, you'd want to make sure just turn on the survey that you want to run in the report, then go back, run the report, you'll be set. Once you're done with your report, if you need to, you can always upload the project file to either a Unity server, iBwave Cloud, or if you needed to save your project to the device and be able to share locally, you can always tell it to save your device. So with that, this is our demo with the 5G using the Epiq PRiSM scanner and mobile survey software. Thank you for your attention.